Hello and welcome. We're at Wise Media's Third America Summit, and I have the pleasure of introducing you to Eduardo Luis Risman, who is the CIO of GRU Airport. It's Latin America's largest airport.
Exactly.
And I heard, Mr. Risman, that there's some dramatic developments. Your airport is doubling capacity. It's modernizing its infrastructures, and I would suspect this is also in view of the major events that Brazil looks forward to hosting in the near future. How many people travel via GRU Airport today?
Yeah, the GRU Airport today handles around 35 million passengers a year, although it has a nominal capacity of handling only 20 million passengers a year. So our main challenge is first to cope with the capacity and prepare ourselves for the big events, as you said. So we are doubling the size of the terminals in order to be able to handle around 45 million passengers a year. And of course, we are looking at the big events, the World Cup next year and the Olympics in 2016, but we are also looking for the future. I mean, this is the main hub in Latin America for international flights, and we have to be able to do that.
So what are the security technologies that you're planning to integrate for the modern Sao Paulo airport?
Yeah, I mean, of course there is an easy but costly way to do that, and that is to put what I used to call concrete. So we can keep building more terminals and more terminals. But what we are looking for, apart from that, and that has to be done anyway, is to produce a more efficient way to handle passengers and baggages. And that hangs specifically on technology. And technology that also brings the way to, you know, make the experience of the passengers a better one, but also to bring the same level of security that is needed in any international airport. So we are deploying quite a lot of new technologies, at least new technologies for Latin America, that will make us able not only to handle more passengers, but to handle them more efficient and more secure. So that means from the way you do your check-in, from the way you drop off your bag, from the way you go through security, from the way you check at the immigration point, and at the end at the boarding gate. And together with that, naturally, we have to be aware that it's not only you that is traveling, but also your bag. Right, so you have to make sure that the technology can handle both, meaning that you and your baggage will arrive at the airplane safely, secure, check it, and at the end that we have the information. And that's very important because we are, you know, in a global world now, and we talk a lot about mobility. And people mostly think about mobility on, you know, using the internet. But today, because of our global economy, people are also mobile. I mean, they are traveling more because they are doing business everywhere. So we need to make sure that not only at our airport everything goes smoothly and secure, but we are able to send the information beforehand to your airport of destination so that they know beforehand that you and your bag is arriving, let's say 10 hours before or 12 hours before or 8 hours before. So the technology and the security application and security equipments that we are putting in place, they not only control what is happening at our airport, but also provides information for the destination airports. So I think this integration is the next step. I mean, the other way around, if you're traveling, let's say, from Frankfurt to Sao Paulo, they will do the same with us. They will do the check, they will do everything electronically, and then we will know beforehand that you are arriving and you have two luggages with you. So we will prepare ourselves to receive you and make our flux, our arrival flux, as good as the departure flux. So the integration is, I think, the main challenge that we have today.
So this is very interesting. I understand that in your priority, advancing passenger data is a very interesting topic that you're getting ready to manage in a very modern way. What about e-gates? Are any infrastructures being created on site at Gurugram Airport to facilitate travel via state-of-the-art passenger?
Yes, that is part of the project. So we are also deploying e-gates. On the case of e-gates, we still have a challenge in the industry, is that to integrate countries, because let's say the Brazilian passport has a chip, so I can check you, I can check if you are who you are at the time of immigration, right? But it's not completely compatible with what the, let's say, the European community is doing, because they also have a chip on their passport. So we have to integrate those two. So I can check you and know that you are what you are saying you are. But I cannot do that with, an Italian citizen, right? Because we have different systems and different smart cards inside the passport. So we probably are going to be solved, the Brazilian citizens traveling abroad on this smooth way of going through all the airport port process, but I will probably not be able to solve the other way around. The same with the Italian airport in Milan or in Rome. So I think that the challenge is to integrate those cases, and of course that will depend not only on the private enterprises like us, but will depend also on government authorities, that they have to reach a point where they can be able to create a standard that if you use your Italian passport to go through an automatic e-gate at Rome, you can use the same thing to go through an e-gate in São Paulo. I think that's the main point. And both systems are completely, they are very, very secure, because they check you, they check your face, they check your fingerprints, they check your data. They even go to a national security database to check your record there. But how do we integrate that to make it easy for everybody everywhere?
So that is very interesting. I would like to ask you something about another aspect that is that we're all familiar with when traveling via airports. Airports are becoming a major point of sale for major brands. They provide this experience to the traveler that is not only a hub for your next destination to be reached more quickly, but a place to spend time and enjoy your part of your journey for a shopping experience. Mm-hmm. Are you planning to invest in the infrastructure of the duty-free to be able to support in a modern way transactions? Is there any additional consideration that we should?
Yes, there is, and that's a very, very interesting and important point, because, you know, to go through a boarding process at an airport, it's a little stressful, right? So, because you have to check in yourself, you have to check your bag, you have to go to security, you have to go to immigration. So that's always a stressful process. So when we bring in technology to make that process more smooth and more enjoyable or easy, I would say not enjoyable, but it's easy to go, because you have, you know, electronic documents and you have electronic equipment that will make you go through faster and easier. Then you get to a shopping center, and then you can relax. If you have an experience that, you know, it takes you a long time and it's complicated to, you know, to check in, to check baggage, to go to security, to go to immigration, then at the end, actually, you're too stressful. You cannot relax. And usually it takes much more time to do that. So you have less time to enjoy yourself and have, a less drink before you board the plane. So what we want to do, and some airports in the world are very and are doing that in a very beautiful way, is that you go through the what used to be, you know, not a good process, a stressful process, to a very smooth one, and then you relax yourself. And that's where you know, and why most you know, brands and companies and chains of restaurants, they are putting a lot more effort in bringing that facility to you inside the airport, because then you have time to relax. So, and then you may buy more, or you may just sit down and have a coffee and talk to, you know, your companion or whoever is traveling with you. So it makes the experience really enjoyable, and not you know, an experience that wow, I have to go to this and to that, and so just go through. So our vision, and that's the vision, is that if you like, since you left the curb at the airport, the first person you would meet and talk to is the crew at the airplane, if you like to. Otherwise, you have still the proper environment to do some shopping, or less time shopping, or to buy the gift for your family that you need, or just to have a coffee to relax before you get into the plane. I mean, that's something that the new terminal in São Paulo is going to have. And of course, because of the big events, we are going to do that in two phases. So the new terminal will have that from beginning, and then we'll come back to the old terminals and do the same.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Ritzman. I think your vision is very clear. We wish you all the best of success in your endeavors to facilitate travel and increase security of GRU Airport. And regards to all from Rio.